We're going to go ahead and start taking a tour. So why don't you guys just climb up the stairs there and climb
last
up.
Flying one in the world.
Is it really?
Is it the last flying one? I thought it was. I said the family had one more
time. All controls work the same way.
Just how they get there.
Now you guys can collect your
job.
You got done and you're halfway there.
Yeah.
All right, here we are on the inside, and basically it's just a large aluminum tube that's set up to transport B-36 crew. Again, originally this helicopter was designed to do Arctic rescue. You would fly 600 miles round trip, pick up 20 people, which is the number of people that was on a B-36 crew, and operate at 65 below zero. This is the heater system up here that heats it, and the walls were covered with insulating blankets to help keep it warm. We can either sit 20 people in seats right here, and these fold down, and then you'd have 20 positions where you can put troops in, or we could put 12 stretchers. And the reason we have the stretchers in here is just to show you what the configuration could be like. They have to do the rescue that big tank back there is the fuel tank, and that's the internal tank. It holds 300 gallons. You notice on the outside there are two drop tanks, one on each side. Those also hold 300 gallons, 150 gallons apiece. And they're what they call drop tanks. So what you do is you fly to the rescue site using the external tanks. When you get to the rescue site, you drop the external tanks and trade the weight that you're leaving for the people that are coming on board. And then you fly home on the internal tank, 300 gallons. So you got about 3 hours in, 3 hours out, which is your maximum range. Helicopters at that time, back in the early 50s, only had a range of about 100 miles and only held three people. So this helicopter was quite revolutionary for its time. Again, it would fly 600 miles round trip and hold 20 people plus the pilot. Everything is operated by cables. If you look up into the cockpit, you'll see all the gauges and everything that are up there. This is the same as it was when it was in Vietnam. This is the same model helicopter that was the first one used in Vietnam in 1961. And the cockpit is basically the same. This particular helicopter was not in Vietnam. Everything that went to Vietnam is probably still over in Vietnam. We can bring them back.
And not looking anywhere near as good as this.
Yes.
I was going to say, it's almost as old as me, and it looks better.
This was built in 1957.
Well, I was built in 1955.
Right, and this design first flew in 1952. For being designed using drafting supplies and slide rules, it's quite phenomenal. The engine that's in this is the same engine that's in the B-17 bomber. And that's 1935 technology. So things have changed a lot since then. Any helicopters that you see flying today with tandem rotors have jet engines in them. And this one has what they call a radial engine. That means it's a round engine. It's got cylinders stacked all the way around it, and it's air-cooled. So it's called a Wright Cyclone engine. It's 1,425 horsepower and 1,820 cubic inches. So it had to be like 9 Volkswagen engines all bolted together. Final sight, we'll go over the stuff in the back.
Said for old school and reliable.
Yeah,
especially bullets, when you're going through the air.
The bullets, the engines are bulletproof. You can lose a cylinder and still keep flying. Not too efficiently, but you can still keep flying.
Well, inefficient and in the air is a lot better than not.
Aluminum. This drop tanks, each one of these tanks is 150 gallons of Jet A. This aircraft runs up to 120 gallons of power. Right now, present price of fuel is $5.50 a gallon. So you understand how much it costs.